Muse for you, awesome websites without code.
Hey, what's up, Musers? John with Muse for you, here to help you build awesome websites without code. And the next widget from the complete video widget that we're gonna go over is the video banner. So with this widget, you can add a full width video banner to your page or set a custom size for the video simply by changing the size of the widget container. You can also reposition the video within the widget container. The Add First widget must be placed at the top of the page before beginning. So here I'll go into Adobe Muse. I have a blank site, it just says video banner. When you download the widget, whether you purchase individually or from the subscription, you'll get a zip file and you'll want to extract that zip file. And in that folder that's extracted, there'll be a folder called video banner. And in that folder, there's the video banner.mulib file, the complete video widget video banner.mulib. So you simply double click on that file and it will install directly into the library panel within Adobe Muse. So here I'll go to the library panel here to the right. And if you don't see the library panel, you can go to Window and then to Library. Okay, and here I'll open the library panel. And within the search, I'll type in CVW. CVW is short for Complete Video Widget. So with the abbreviation CVW, it makes it really easy to find the widget within the library panel. So here we have the Complete Video Widget full screen, the Complete Video Widget video banner, and the Complete Video Widget video player. So we're gonna work with the video banner. So here I'll click on the CVW Add First video banner, and I'll want to place this at the top of the page before beginning. So I'll just click, hold, and drag and place right in there. And then I'll go ahead and click on CVW video banner and just click, hold, and drag and place into Adobe Muse. So right away we get this widget container that's 500 pixels in width and 300 pixels in height. And we also have a video guide initially letting us know a few more details about self-hosted video. So in the video guide, it says add a poster image and at least a .mp4 video. Most browsers support .mp4 video. Video will play locally in Google Chrome and Firefox and will play on all other browsers once uploaded to a live server. The video will loop once it is on a live server. For full width video, select the widget and then within the resize option in the upper toolbar, select stretch to browser width. The recommended size for self-hosted video is 4 to 8 megabytes. Okay, so it's just a nice little guide there in case you had any questions about self-hosted video and using the widget. So I'll go ahead and open up the widget options. So here, the first section is instance number. So if you have multiple videos on the site, each video will want to have its own unique instance number. Otherwise, the different instances won't play. Only the first instance of the widget would play if they all have the same instance number. So with each new video, you want to make sure that it has a unique instance number. Okay, and then going down to the next section, which is the video section, here we can select the video. So most browsers support a .mp4 video file, so in most cases, you'll just have to add a .mp4 video file. You can add a .webm file for fallback supports on browsers that don't support .mp4 video, but again, most browsers do support .mp4 video, so in most cases, you can just add a .mp4 video file. You will want to upload a poster image, so on devices that require user input to play video, the poster image will show instead. With this widget, you can add a play button at a specific breakpoint so that on tablet and mobile devices, the user is able to view the video by clicking the play button. But again, with full width video, I usually recommend not having a play button and just letting the poster image show on those devices. If you did want a video player with playback controls, I would recommend the video player widgets within the complete video widget. But that is an option to add the play button. I've had a few requests for that, so if you did want to have a play button so the user could still view the video, you can add that at a specific breakpoint. And I'll go over that in this video tutorial. Okay, and then we have the video fitting, so you can scale to fill or scale to fit, similar to filling a rectangle with an image or fitting the image within the rectangle. And if the video is larger than the widget container, you can reposition it within the widget container on the X and Y axis within percentage-based values. Okay, so that's the video section, so I'll go ahead and add a video. So here where it says select MP4 file, I'll click add file, and I'll select a video here. Okay, and then I'll select the poster image for the video. So I'll click Add File, and I'll select the poster image, just like that. Once you select the poster image, it covers the video guide, so you have a good reference of where the video is on your website. So I'm gonna go ahead and stretch it to browser width, or actually before I do that, I'll go ahead and preview. The video will work right away, and it'll be within this widget container. So I'll go to File, right up here, then Preview Page in Browser. Okay, and just like that, we have the video playing within the widget container, and it's set to autoplay. Okay, so I'll go back into Muse, and I'll set it to stretch to browser width, so it spans the full width of the website. So here in the resize option, right up here in the upper toolbar, I'll click the dropdown and say stretch to browser width. Okay, just like that, and then I'll go ahead and preview, and there we have the video. So if I wanted it to be a banner, I could just place it at the top, right click, arrange, send to back. I could change the height simply by dragging the widget container. So I'll set a height of 350 pixels, and I'll move this text and this rectangle in the center. All right, so just like that, we have a nice video banner. I'll go ahead and preview, and perfect. I can resize, and the video resizes within the widget container. Looks good. I can set a few breakpoints, and yeah, I'll set a few breakpoints. And the video will look good across all breakpoints. So I'll just resize this in here, or reposition it in here. And looks good. And that looks good. All right. Perfect. So I'll go ahead and preview. And there we go. So I resize. There we have this breakpoint and the last breakpoint. All right, so the video does reload across each breakpoint just to ensure that the video plays across all breakpoints and looks good. So I can resize the browser. There it reaches the 600 breakpoint, then the 480 breakpoint. So the video does reload across breakpoints just to ensure that it plays even when the breakpoint changes, but your users most likely won't be resizing the browser like this when they're viewing the website. Initially, when they load on a specific breakpoint, the video will play right away, unless it's on a tablet and mobile device that requires user input. All right, looks good. So that's the video banner. If I were to add another video, so I'll copy and paste, and I'll change the instance number to 2. And this is just to demonstrate the instance number. And I'll add another video and change the poster image as well. So we'll have 2 videos playing. So there's the first video and here's the second. I'll close a few tabs because I have quite a few videos open. But yeah, there's the first video and the second video. If I were to have the same instance number for each, so if I were to change this to instance number 1, and I go ahead and preview, we're gonna notice that the second video doesn't play. All right, so it's really important if you do have multiple instances or multiple videos, video banners, just change the instance number for each one. Okay, and I could say scale to fit, and it'll just fit the video within the container there, within the widget container. All right, looks good. I'll close some of these tabs, and perfect. All right, so usually I like to say scale to fill, just to have it fill the entire width of the browser. I'll go ahead and delete the second video, and we'll just work with this first one here. So I'll go through the other options here, the other sections. So we can add an overlay to the video. So if I were to select enable overlay color, we'll have a blue color over the video, and you can select any color you'd like. So now we have this blue overlay over the video. You can set the opacity for the overlay. So within the overlay opacity, if I were to set it to something higher, like 0.8, the video would be less visible and that blue color would be more visible. So you can choose a value between 0 and 1 for the opacity, and there we go. Okay, so I'll go back into the widget options. You can also add a mesh overlay. Let me change this back to 0.2. You can also add a mesh overlay by selecting enable mesh overlay. And then here, we have a website called patternify.com, and I'll go ahead and click on patternify.com, and here you can create your own pattern or your own mesh. They have a few presets here, so I'll click here on this preset, and then you want to copy the base64 code right here. So you just click in this section, and then I'll hit Command C to copy. I'll go back into the widget, and for the overlay section right here I'll hit Command V to paste where it says replace with base64 data from patternify.com. So I'll just enter it right in there, and perfect. And I'll go ahead and preview. And just like that, we have a mesh overlay over the video. All right, so that looks good. You can also add an image for the mesh overlay. So if you have a pattern, like a PNG pattern, you can add it here where it says add file to have that mesh overlay over the video. All right, looks good. So I'll go ahead and uncheck mesh overlay, and I'll uncheck enable color overlay as well because I just want the video there. All right, looks good. So that's the overlay section. Then we have the options section. So here we have the options. So you can autoplay the video, which I would recommend if you're gonna have full width video. So as soon as the website loads, the video will start to play. You can loop the video, which I also recommend for video banners. You can mute the audio. I do recommend this because Safari has been recently updated so that if video has audio, it won't play unless it has a play button. So the user has to click a play button if the video has audio. And also for video banners, you wouldn't normally have audio. So I would recommend leaving the audio muted. Then we have preload, which I would also recommend as well. So the video can start loading as soon as the website starts loading as well. And then play inline on tablet and mobile. So if you did have a play button for tablet and mobile devices, the video would play right on the page rather than going into a full screen mode where you know all the playback controls are there. Rather than going to that full screen, it'll play right in the page so the user doesn't have to kind of click out of a video player. It'll just play right on the page. All right, so let's go to the next section, which is the play button section. So if you did want the play button for devices that require user input, you can add a play and pause button. So again, this is really only necessary if you really need the user to view that video banner on the device. I myself don't mind if the video is just a poster image on tablet and mobile devices. Or another thing you could do is hide the video banner on lower breakpoints and just change the layout of the site so it doesn't use video banners and just has a really clean layout for a tablet and mobile devices. But if you did want a play button, you could just click here where it says add file, click add file. And then within the widget folder, there's a folder called play and pause buttons. So it comes with these buttons that you can use for the play and pause. You can also use any custom play and pause buttons for your video banner. So here I'll select the play button, and you can change the width of the play button as well to make it larger or smaller. And I'll add a pause button. So here I'll select the pause button, and the same thing, I can change the width to make it larger or smaller. I can change the percentage from the top. So here it's gonna be 50% from the top of the video banner. So it'll be right in the center. For this, I'd probably place it closer to the bottom. So I might say like 70%. So it doesn't cover anything in the center of the video banner. And here's where you'll set the breakpoint for when you want the play button to appear. So let's say I wanted it to appear for smaller devices. I'd set, you know, a breakpoint like 480. And I go to file, preview page, and browser. We don't see the play button yet, but if I resize to the 480 breakpoint, we can see the play button shows right here. And I might bring it a little bit lower, so I'll change the percentage. So right in here, I'll say 80% from the top. And I'll preview. And we can see the play button there. So we can see the video's not playing because on the breakpoint where the play button is, it's looking for user input. So if I click play, the video will start playing. If I pause, the video will pause. If I start on a breakpoint larger than 480, the video will just autoplay because it's not looking for user input. But if the website is opened on a device that's 480 pixels or less, the play button will appear and the user can click the play button or touch the play button to play the video. So I have it here on my iPhone 8 Plus. So I'll go ahead and demonstrate it. So here when I click the play button, the video starts playing on my iPhone 8 Plus. So because play inline on tablet and mobile is checked, the video doesn't go into full screen mode and I don't have to, you know, go through the video with playback controls and things like that. It just automatically plays within the page on my device. So I can pause it, play it. Looks good. Okay, so the last thing I'll go over is, let's say you didn't want the video on lower breakpoints. You could just right click on the video within that breakpoint and select hide in breakpoint. So I'll remove it for the 480 and the 600 breakpoint. So here I'll just right click and select hide in breakpoint. So now it'll just be at the 960 breakpoint, and when it reaches the 600 breakpoint, the video will not be there. All right, so I'll go to file, preview page in browser, and we can see there's no video. And then at the 960 breakpoint, we have the video. So we started at the 480 breakpoint. So in this case, I'll go to the play button and I'll change the breakpoint value to 0 so that the play button won't appear and the video won't look for any user input and will just autoplay across any width. Okay, so I'll go ahead and preview, and there we go. So we can see the video plays when it reaches the 600 breakpoint mark. So here it disappears because we've hit it on the 600 and the 480 breakpoint. And then once we get to the 600, we have the video. Perfect. Okay, so that's the video banner widget. Here we have the different widget options. There's a few references here as well on how to use the widget. Again, we have that nice video guide as well when you first add the widget. So you can take a look there as well. And perfect. So that's the video banner in the complete video widget. So to access the complete video widget, you simply go to museforyoushop.com, and here you can click subscribe today. And here you can click subscribe now to get access to all widgets and templates I come out with for $39 a year. Here we have the complete video widget, and here you can click add to cart to purchase individually, or again, you can click subscribe to get access to all widgets and templates for $39 a year. Here we have a description of the complete video widget, the community section if you had any questions about the widget, and the video will be right here as well, and a few of the widget options from the complete video widget. Okay, so that's it for this video tutorial. The next video tutorial in the complete video widget series is going to be the video player. Okay, so that's it for this video tutorial. Again, I do this to help you build awesome websites without code. If you like this video tutorial, you can subscribe below. Also, in the show more section below are links to other resources and links to museforyoushop.com. So again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video tutorial. Thank you.
Muse for You, awesome websites without code.